tells us that we're to leave our father and mother and become one flesh with the person that we choose to spend the rest of our lives with. Not that we do away with who we are as individuals, but now we function as one. Not only are the two of you becoming one, but you got your Lord and Savior creating a strand of three cords that doesn't break. Linked together by the promise that God has made.
He slept on my floor. He just took care of me in a way that I think no other partner ever has. And that's just when I knew that I really, really loved him, because he shows to me what God's sacrificial love really is.
I knew Kathy was the one the first time we went to California to visit my family, and my family all loved her. And she got along great with them and just seamlessly fell into the close-knit, you know, family dynamic that we have. They pulled me aside and they're like, we love her. I knew she was the one.
He learns a lot more through experimentation and doesn't worry about whether something is going to turn out right or not. If it doesn't turn out right, he just changes his plan, you know, and it doesn't get him rattled. And then the other thing that I've always loved about him is his sense of adventure and his sense of kindness.
One of my favorite things is she's tall, but she has a great heart. She almost cares too much sometimes, and it could cause her some stress, but at the same time, it's one of the best things about her.
He's really good at calming me down and kind of bringing me back into reality and helping me see that a lot of things that I'm scared of or that I worry about, you know, in God's greater plan, he's just been able to talk about those things through with me ever since I kind of got sick. And so made me grow that way a lot.
Think of the logic here with me for just a minute. If God is love, we can replace the word love with God. So it reads, God is patient and kind. God does not envy or boast. God is not arrogant or rude, and on and on. And then, since you two are living in love, God lives in you. Really replace the word love with Jeff and Kathy. So it reads, Jeff is patient. Jeff and Kathy are not arrogant or rude. Kathy does not insist on her own way. Jeff's not irritable or resentful. But here's the reality. God is growing you two up to be these very things for each other. Well, it's now my great honor to say, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Jeff, you may kiss your bride.